Welcome back, everybody. Mike Lyons here in the First Alert Weather Center. The latest information on Hurricane Beryl. I think the key phrase or the key word as we head toward the weekend regarding this storm is surprise. It's already had plenty of surprises over the past 24 hours. And as we look at the new advisory from the Hurricane Center, the storm continuing to track toward the Lesser Antilles. The new advisory does include a hurricane watch now for the island of Barbados. Now, as you look at the system, it certainly doesn't appear to have that classic look of a hurricane. Now, does it? But according to the National Hurricane Center, it is still just that, a Category 1 hurricane sitting there in the middle of the Atlantic. At the 5 o'clock advisory, winds right now remain 80, and the storm is moving toward the west at 15 miles per hour. Earlier, Hurricane Center thought the storm might get a bit stronger and become a Category 2 hurricane. At the moment, we think it will remain a Category 1, but it's extremely tiny. Think of it in this terms, it's about the same size as Manhattan, or to put it another way, if you drove from Jupiter to West Palm Beach, that's how big this hurricane is. So wherever it does impact, it will be a powerful punch, but again, it will be really isolated. As we head into the first part of next week, Monday and Tuesday, upper level wind shear will rip the system apart. Meanwhile, a brand new tropical depression has formed here off the coastline of the Carolinas. This is tropical depression number 3. Likely to become a tropical storm on Saturday, perhaps a hurricane over the next couple of days. Its track, it is forecast to sit right about here for the next several days, then eventually move out to sea, may bring some squally weather and rough surf to the Outer Banks of North Carolina. And that is the latest on the tropics.